Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas, welcome to this video. This is the Legacy build. Here we have it, the Legacy level 74 Berserker class. This is the guy, and we are in legendary difficulty. This is the Mimer's Maze, and if you know about this place, this is where there is a good chance that you will meet some of duplicates, the doppelgangers of your character. Which means there is a chance I will meet my character. He will come out of the ground and he will try to kill me, and I will have to beat him if I am lucky enough to meet my doppelganger. There is of course a chance that you will meet up to 2 or even 3 doppelgangers in this place. It is all about luck. It is random. So if you have this luck, you will meet them and you will probably kill them, or they will kill you. It depends on your build actually. So, we are here. I'm going for the first time through this area. We are very close to the end of the campaign with this character, legendary difficulty. And here we are. For the first time I will explore the whole area, and hopefully, or maybe not that hopefully, but hopefully we will meet at least one doppelganger of mine, because you know, the good thing about the doppelgangers is that there is a small chance when you kill them, they will drop some of the items that you wear, armor or weapon items, not artifact or jewels, and there is a chance that they will duplicate one or two or even three of your items, and they will drop them to the ground for you to pick them up. So they could, for example, duplicate this one, and of course the numbers are random of the dupe, but it doesn't really matter. They could duplicate this one, or this one, or this one, or maybe this one, or this one, or this one. And this is why this doppelganger thing is very good. It is a feature that came with Ragnarok. It is amazing actually, but of course, depending on your build, you may die from your doppelganger. I don't know, I have never met my doppelgangers with this build, the legacy build. I don't know, I think that if I meet a doppelganger, he will kill me, unless I'm faster than him to summon my outsiders, my ancestral warriors, not outsiders. Outsider belong to the outsider build, spirit mastery, and if I am quick enough to summon my battle standard or even use my guardian stones. These are the skills of this build, the legacy build. So, let's go. Let's go. Summon your guys. Summon this thing. Let's go, everybody. Oh, very easy. These enemies are very easy. These enemies are very bad, the ghosts. Yeah, this is why they are very bad. Come on. I don't want to be next to this ghost when it dies, because it blows up. It uses a spellbreaker skill when it dies. This spellbreaker skill is very bad, because it can disrupt your skills. Some of the skills get disrupted, and when this happens you lose the skills, and if those skills keep you alive, you die. So, two more ghosts. I will have to stay far away, keep my distance from these ghosts. It seems that I also have the wall. We don't have a doppelganger here. This is a place where usually doppelgangers spawn. One of the places, there are more places of course, but this is one of the good places. Okay, forget about this. What is this guy doing? This guy was trying to destroy my... yeah, nice. No! As you can see, this is a problem with this ghost, the spellbreaker skill. It disrupts my very nice skills. Let me do this thing. Oh, did you see that? My skills are gone. Again. Okay. I don't have enough energy. Let's go now. Take the battle marker. Let's see here. Nothing. Very annoying enemies. Super annoying. Okay, skill is on. When I started playing this character, this build, I was using a shield. I have my shield. This is the shield, the Priam's Gate. This shield is amazing because it provides too many resistances for survivability. Survivability, there I said it, it is amazing. But then I decided to equip this one because this one provides bonus to pets damage at health, conversion to health. We don't really got conversion to health for warriors, these guys here, but we need the total damage. And it is also a very good item because that version that I have, which is upgraded, also gives me some survivability, attack damage converted to health. So it helps greatly. This is one of the places that Doppelganger may spawn. But this time we didn't get a Doppelganger. I feel like I won't get any Doppelganger today. Yeah. Once again, my skills are dead. Summon the guys. And say to them 1,000,000 goodbyes. Wise. Yes, boss, yes, I do. I'm coming to get you. Yo. Oh, yeah. Okay. Once again. So, with this build, we have 80% reduction to the cooldown of our skills. In this game it is called Recharge Reduction. And which means that we can be casting, as you see I have one battle standard, I can cast a second one if I want to, right now. Which helps very much with this build, because of the style, the play style of the build. Which of course the idea is to have as many ancestral warriors as possible, as often as possible actually. And to do that, one way is to have this skill reduced as much as possible. The maximum reduction that we can have is 80%. So now, right now I have 80%, so I can be using this skill every 60 seconds. 60 seconds recharge time. Put this in here. Let's go. Okay, there are chances to fight the Doppelganger somewhere here or here. We will see. I hope we are lucky enough to fight at least one. I got mostly to know if my build is powerful enough to kill me. How to kill me? Of course, the Doppelganger will kill me. Yes, here it is. Wow. This is it. My Doppelganger. Oh no. He couldn't kill me. Where is no. Nothing, just gold. Unfortunately. Okay, this is very good. So, this build is very powerful against your Doppelganger. What the fuck? Doppelganger. What is going on here? Okay. Okay. Yeah. As I was saying, my Doppelganger is not powerful enough to kill me. This is good news. We can farm as much as we want doppelgangers with this build, but of course it makes sense to farm doppelgangers only if you want to duplicate your items. And to do that, it would take you lots and lots of time, too many runs. You know, doppelgangers do not spawn every time that you come here, and also they do not duplicate your items every time you kill them. This is a very rare thing. Come on, focus. I killed myself there. That was damage reflection. Yeah. Damage reflection. Oh no, not again. Can we fight one more, please? Doppelganger. I didn't even understand what this guy asked right now. He said something like, "Are you sure you are going the right way?" Maybe. But I'm not really sure. Okay, let's keep going. We are getting there to the boss fight. We are really getting there. You know, about this build, I will make a build guide video. I hope this build guide video will come soon enough. I mean, after I complete the campaign with this character, which is actually, this is one of the last areas of the game in Ragnarok, so yeah, we will complete the campaign very soon, so we will have a couple of videos, a build guide, and a couple of more videos probably for this build very soon, so stay tuned. Opa. The bad thing is that we cannot convert damage to health against these enemies. And this is something that can kill me here. Okay. Let's see. The doppelganger here, no. Yes! Yes, here he comes! Wow! Wow! No, you will not, you will not. No, I'm dying because of something, I don't know. Summon this skill. The blah, 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 blah. The damage reflection from the guys. Why did this two come? We don't want you here. Yes, ha. Oh yeah, baby, yeah. That was a very, 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 how do you call it? I don't know the word in English, anyway. That was a very funny battle, I could say. You know, I didn't even hit my doppelganger, it was my ancestral warriors and also the guardian stones that dealt damage to this doppelganger here. I was trying to... When you saw my health going down rapidly, it was because I was hitting a little bit these guys, the golems, when they had reflected damage on. This is why I was dying, and I was trying to avoid them. This is why I was running back and forth, and I didn't really try to hit my enemies. That was super funny, very nice, but again, I didn't get any duplicates of my items. Oops. Yeah, okay, mechanical parts. So, how many have I killed? Two, I think two doppelgangers. I don't even remember, I think it is two. 2. I'm very happy with 2 doppelgangers. Let's go for the boss now. Yeah, when these guys are in this stance, they reflect the damage. You should hit them only when they are on their feet, at walking, at trying to hit you. Okay, there are no more ghosts here. Yep. And here we go. So,
there we are.
Yeah, there we are. So, let's go for the boss fight. This is going to be interesting. I want to know if this build can destroy this boss fast enough. This boss is a bit of a trickster. It is a tricky one. Of course, I will activate Guardian Stones, everything that I have in my disposal. So, use this one, use that one, and let's go.
Let's go.
One is down, two is down. And the boss is down, baby! Yeah! How did I? I did because I'm a crazy Greek guy. Oh, we get a legendary set item, Pillars of Karnos. Yeah, the story of my life. Pillars of Karnos. Karnos. Okay, I don't really need this item, but I will keep it. I think I have it already in my mules. Just one legendary, but at least we got a legendary and also set. It is not just a legendary, it is also a set. So, very easy. Very easy. Yeah. So guys, this is the build, the legacy build in Mimer's Maze. It was a nice run, funny run. We met 2 at least doppelgangers. We didn't get any items duplicates from them, unfortunately. But as we saw, this build is very powerful against doppelgangers because mostly I didn't see doppelgangers using these skills here. And if they don't use these skills here and I use the skills here, of course we destroy this guy here. So, in a way, we could say that with the doppelgangers in this map, you can check out the weaknesses of your build, because your build is trying to kill you. And you see that if the doppelganger, which is your build, does not use some of the skills, and you use them, you can see how your build performs when it is not using the skills and when it is using the skills. Maybe something like that. But anyway, this is it. Very soon I hope I will finish the campaign with this guy. I will bring the build guide video, of course, for those interested to know more about the build, everything. And maybe more videos for this guy, a couple of more videos maybe, who knows. So thanks for watching everybody. If you haven't yet subscribed, we have lots of Titan Quest content coming, especially with the new things that will come in the Titan Quest in the near future with the new updates and patches and all of these things. We will be here forever for Titan Quest. So I will see you very soon with live streams, more content, more videos, everything. Have fun!